Welcome to weekly weather review and weather outlook for next 2 weeks of the India Meteorological Department. And if we see that in the previous week, the southwest monsoon has advanced into some more parts of Maldives, Comorian area, southwest and east central Bay of Bengal, most parts of southeast Bay of Bengal and some parts of west central Bay of Bengal on 27th of May. And the northern limit of monsoon that remained the same during the 27th May and 2nd of June. And in the previous week, there had been few cyclonic circulations and few troughs which developed for the very short durations over the various parts of the country. This is the satellite imagery of the cloud convection over the Indian region. It can be seen that there was the convection over the central parts of the country, parts of the East India and Bay of Bengal. If we see that on 27th of May, the highest maximum temperature of 45.5 degrees centigrade was reported in the Bikaner in West Rajasthan, and heavy to very heavy rainfall with extremely heavy falls were also reported at isolated places over Odisha and Jharkhand. Heavy to very heavy rainfall reported over the Kerala and Mahe and Lakshadweep area, and heavy rainfall reported over the Arunachal Pradesh, West Bengal, Sikkim, Chhattisgarh and Tamil Nadu on 27th May. Similarly, on the 28th May, the highest maximum temperature of 47.3 degrees centigrade was reported at Ganganagar in the West Rajasthan. Heavy to very heavy rainfall reported with extremely heavy falls reported at isolated places over Sub-Himalayan West Bengal and Sikkim, Jharkhand and Bihar. Heavy to very heavy rainfall reported over the Gangetic West Bengal. On 29th May, the 46.3 degrees centigrade was the highest maximum temperature at Ganganagar in West Rajasthan, and heavy to very heavy falls reported with extremely heavy falls reported over the East UP and Bihar. On 30th May, the highest maximum temperature was 45.5 degrees centigrade at Churu in West Rajasthan, and heavy rainfall reported at isolated places over Himachal Pradesh, Kerala and Mahe. On 31st, the 44 degrees centigrade was the highest maximum temperature at Bikaner, and extremely heavy rainfall was reported at Assam and Meghalaya. On 1st of June, the 43.4 degrees centigrade was the highest maximum temperature at Agra in West UP, and heavy to very heavy rainfall recorded over the Odisha and Assam and Meghalaya. Similarly, on the 2nd of June, the 42.4 degrees centigrade was the highest maximum temperature, which was reported at Raisen in West Madhya Pradesh, and heavy to very heavy rainfall reported over Sub-Himalayan West Bengal and Sikkim. If we see the amount wise, on 27th of May, 8 cm rainfall was reported in Arunachal Pradesh, 9 cm reported over the Sub-Himalayan West Bengal and Sikkim, 11 cm was reported at Harbour in Diamond Harbour and Gangetic West Bengal, 28 cm rainfall reported in Odisha, 21 cm in Jharkhand and 11 cm in Chhattisgarh. On 28th of May, Andaman Nicobar Island reported the 7 cm rainfall, Sikkim reported the 31 cm rainfall at Malda, and GWB, that is the Gangetic West Bengal, reported the 13 cm of rainfall. Similarly, on 29th May, Bihar reported 21 cm rainfall, East UP reported 21 cm rainfall, Coastal Karnataka reported the 11 cm of rainfall. And these are the observed rainfall values in the centimeter at the different stations are given here. We can see that on 1st of June, the Arunachal Pradesh reported 8 cm rainfall. On 2nd of June, Assam Meghalaya reported 16 cm rainfall. And if we look into the observed rainfall during the previous week, that is from the 27th of May to 2nd June, during this period, the country as a whole received the 30.2 millimeter rainfall against the 17.3 millimeter rainfall, which is the 75% higher side. And out of the four homogeneous regions in the country, except the South Peninsular India, all the remaining three homogeneous regions received the above normal rainfall. However, the South Peninsular India received the below normal rainfall, that is the 16.9 millimeter rainfall against the 20.7 millimeter rainfall, which is the 18% lesser rainfall. And in the right hand side, if we see that this is the rainfall observed during the 1st of March to 31st of May. During this period, the country as a whole received 155.2 millimeter rainfall against the normal value of 131.7 millimeter rainfall, which is the 18% higher rainfall. And in the homogeneous region, Northwest India, Central India and South Peninsular India received the above normal rainfall. However, the East and Northeast India received the below normal rainfall, that is the 344.4 millimeter rainfall against the 376 millimeter rainfall, which is the 9% lesser rainfall. If we look into the advancement of southwest monsoon, today, the 3rd of June, more than 60% of the 14 rainfall monitoring stations reported the 2.5 millimeter or more rainfall in the past 2 days. And special distribution of the rainfall over Kerala had also remained fairly widespread in the past 2 days. If you look into the wind pattern, the westerly winds have been strengthened in the lower levels. That winds are roughly about 20 knots, and based on the satellite derived winds, they suggest that winds are off in the range of 15 to 20 knots, which prevails up to 600 HPA, and winds are the westerly as in today. And if you look into the outgoing long wave radiation, so because of the persistent convection over the Lakshadweep and adjoining Southeast Arabian Sea along and off Kerala coast and Maldiv area, the outgoing long wave radiation value is less than 200 watt per meter square in the given area. So all the basic three conditions are fulfilling the criteria for the onset of the monsoon over the Kerala. So the southwest monsoon has set in over Kerala today, the 3rd of June 2021, against the normal date of 1st of June. So in the left hand side in the figure, we can see that these red color lines are the climatological dates of the advancement of southwest monsoon, and the green lines represents the actual advancement of the southwest monsoon. And the northern limit of monsoon as on today passes through the 10 degree of north, longitude 60 degree of east to the then Cochin, then it passes through the 14 degree north and 90 degree east, then 17 degree north and 94 degree east, that is the extreme eastern end of the monsoon, northern limit of monsoon. And the southwest monsoon is also likely to advance into remaining parts of South Arabian Sea, some parts of Central Arabian Sea, remaining parts of Kerala and Lakshadweep, some more parts of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, some parts of coastal and south interior Karnataka, Rayalaseema, and some more parts of south and central Bay of Bengal during next 2 days. Southwest monsoon is also likely to advance in northeast India during subsequent 2 to 3 days. And this monsoon is likely to advance most parts of South Peninsular India, entire Northeast India by the end of week one. And Southwest monsoon is likely to advance into East and Central India mainly in week two. If we look into the today's main chief synoptic features, the Southwest monsoon has set in over the Kerala on today, because all the three basic criteria are fulfilling. And today there was a cyclonic circulation over equatorial Indian Ocean and adjoining central parts of the South Bay of Bengal between 3.1 and 4.5 km above mean sea level. Today there is an east-west air zone that basically runs from the Southwest Arabian Sea to Southeast Bay of Bengal, across extreme southern peninsular, across roughly along 8 degree north latitude at 3.1 km above mean sea level. Today, there is a north-south trough which basically runs from Telangana to South Tamil Nadu in lower tropospheric levels, and the western disturbance in the mid and upper tropospheric levels runs roughly along 72 degree east and north of 30 degree north. And if this is the weather warning for the next 5 days, so if you see on today, that is 3rd of June, we are expecting the heavy rainfall over parts of South Peninsular India and thunderstorm activities over the parts of Central India, Northwest India, South Peninsular India, as well as the adjoining East India. On 4th of June, we are expecting some heavy rainfall over the parts of Maharashtra, Telangana, Rayalaseema, coastal Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. And thunderstorm activities are likely to be over the parts of Central India and Western Himalayan region. On 5th of June, the heavy rainfall we are expecting over the Northeast India, over the Konkan and Goa, over the North interior Karnataka, coastal Karnataka, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. And thunderstorm activity will continue over the Central India and adjoining West India. On 6th of June, the heavy rainfall we are expecting over the Northeast India, and thunderstorm activity over the parts of Central India, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, and Gujarat. On 7th of June, the thunderstorm activity will continue over the parts of Central India, Gujarat state, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, and heavy rainfall over the Sikkim and Assam and Meghalaya. And this is the forecast, rainfall forecast for the week 1 and week 2. And below are the rainfall anomaly forecast for the week 1 and week 2. So if you look into the week 1, there will be the above normal rainfall over the parts of Central India and adjoining South Peninsular India and adjoining West India also, and there will be the and Northeast India also, there will be above normal rainfall, and there will be the below normal rainfall over the Sub-Himalayan West Bengal and Sikkim, and in the remaining parts of the country we are expecting normal rainfall in the week 1. If you look into the week 2, there will be the above normal rainfall activity all along the west coast, parts of the Central India and adjoining East India, and there will be the below normal rainfall activity in the Northeast India, and normal rainfall over the remaining parts of the country. In the week 1, we are also expecting the heavy rainfall over the Kerala, Karnataka, Konkan and Goa, Madh Maharashtra during first half of the week, over Andaman and Nicobar Island during the second half of the week, over the Arunachal Pradesh during 4th to 6th of June, over Assam and Meghalaya during 3rd to 9th of June, and over the Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Tripura during the 5th to 9th of June. In the first week, and if we look into the week 2, that is from 11th of June to 17th of June, so due to the likely strengthening of the westerly winds and offshore trough along the west coast, rainfall activity is very likely to increase over the South Peninsular India, and there will be the above normal rainfall over the parts of Maharashtra, coastal and north interior Karnataka, Kerala, Telangana, coastal Andhra Pradesh, south Chhattisgarh, adjoining Odisha and East UP, and below normal rainfall is likely over parts of Himachal Pradesh, Sub-Himalayan West Bengal and Sikkim, and entire north eastern states, and the normal rainfall likely over the rest parts of the country. And this is the forecast for the cyclonogenesis in the week 1 and week 2. So the monsoon depression is likely to form over northwest bay of Bengal with the moderate probability. Means the moderate probability during the first half of the week. So because of this monsoon depression over the northwest bay of Bengal, we will receive the good amount of rainfall over the northwest bay of Bengal and adjoining parts of the Odisha, West Bengal and Nevarud area. So that is a good news, means there will be the enhanced rainfall activity over the region. And this is the temperature forecast for the week 1. in the left hand side figure is the maximum temperature forecast for the week 1, and right hand side figure is the maximum temperature anomaly. So if we look into the anomaly part, so there will be the above normal maximum temperature over the parts of Bihar, Odisha and Saurashtra and Kutch. There will be the normal maximum temperature, below normal maximum temperature likely over the most parts of central India and adjoining South Peninsular India. However, we are expecting the normal maximum temperature over the rest part of the country, and there is no heat wave conditions likely over any part of the country. Similarly, in the week 2, the above normal maximum temperature likely over the Saurashtra and Kutch, Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, West, Uttarakhand and Northeastern states. There will be the below normal maximum temperature over the most parts of central and adjoining South Peninsular India and normal temperature over the rest part of the country in the week 2. And same as in the week 1, in the week 2 also there is no chance of the heat wave in any part of the country.